you can easily imagine a herd of horses running up that hill. This was part of their life and part of their genetic predisposition. It puts the past together with the present.
Santa Cruz Island horse is a breed of horse that came off Santa Cruz Island off the coast of California. They were removed in the early 2000s. They were believed to have been brought over during the Spanish conquistador period of time. When we find groups of horses or any type of animals generally on an island, there's a lot of restrictions, especially in terms of genetics. However, there's only 60 of these horses left. We're doing research to look at how to preserve the breed for future generations to come. It's really important, I think, to come to the island and see where the natural resources were located. So you can see why the horses stayed on this side of the island. The other side, the terrain's really rugged. And the fact that the forage is such at a short stage, then there's a lot less fiber in it, so the horses can get more out of it. Granted, there's absolutely no water content. So that means that the horses were probably really, as we know, efficient in terms of what they did eat and could easily maintain their body weight.
I mean, it's actually a pretty harsh environment. Yes. But then horses are actually used to living in some very harsh environments. Equids can live in very harsh environments.
If they're related to the Iberian breeds, like the older genetic testing suggested, then that's a very arid, dry climate as well. So they genetically should have been adapted. We think because they were on that island that a few of the effects that we see now, such as the gentle nature, possibly came from the lack of no predators. Also the size of the horse, they are a smaller horse. That also might be related to the limited amount of nutrition that's found when you live on an island.
They're wild, they're gentle, they're intelligent, they're trainable. They almost seem like an untouched, pristine animal.
There's about 20 horses here at El Campeon Farms, and we've tried to bring in different colleagues at the university that specialize in reproduction, genetics, and my specialty is in equine science, looking at the husbandry and management of these horses.
This season, for the first time, we're doing some outcrossing. Do everything we can so that this animal survives and not as anything other than the animal that it is today. We don't want to enhance its ability to jump or to run.
Part of the work that I've done is looking at all their body parts blend together, then trying to find another breed of horse that complements how these horses look. So I've taken measurements literally from head to tail, and then we've tried to use that information and correlate it to other stallions from these breeds like Lusitanas and Andalusians, which we believe they're closely related to find horses that complement or match up in those angles. You know, everybody claims something that's bigger and better about their breed of horse. But the one thing that I've said time and time again, and just about everybody that's interacted with the Santa Cruz Island horse, is how friendly they are, how gentle, how docile. It's a piece of history of California. If we lose these genetics, we lose these horses, we lose that history and a piece of our heritage. So I think it's really important to try to preserve for future generations.